guys and gals and monkeys and mushes. It's me, Uncle Johnjohn. And guess what? It's a new year and a new season of this show, where I tell you a story from pictures that I find when I'm riding my bicycle around my neighborhood, or when I'm outside and I'm shoveling the snow so it's safe for my neighbors to come visit me, but they don't visit me because it's not safe to visit. Not right now. Not yet. But I'm getting ready. I'm getting ready for it to be safe for my neighbors to visit me. So sometimes I shovel the snow. It's good to do that. And that means when I do that, I sometimes find things on the ground. I find pictures sometimes. No, I don't. I find them on the internet. And sometimes people on the internet, they give pictures to me. And all of the pictures are free pictures. Anyone can use them because they come from a long, 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 long time ago. And anyone can use them if they want to. And that's why I can use them to tell a story. And that is what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to show you the first picture. And if you're listening to this, I'm going to describe the picture to you and tell you a bedtime story and help you and your brothers and your sisters and your mom and your dad and maybe your other mom and maybe your other dad. And maybe you just have one mom. That's okay. And maybe you just have one dad. That's okay. I mean, who knows? And they will fall asleep with you while you hear me tell you a bedtime story. And tonight's story is about a knight. And do you know what a knight is? Well, I'll tell you what a knight is. A knight is kinda like a soldier from a long time ago. And actually, these were soldiers who were kinda like, they were like rich people too. Yeah, in the old days, when you were a rich person, you also had to be a soldier sometimes. Yeah, it's kinda like your job. And so in the old days, when you were a soldier, it was like a really important job to have sometimes. And because it was important, you had a lot of respect. People really admired you. And that's why they didn't call you a soldier. They gave you a special word. They called you a knight. And because you were a knight, when people talked to you, they would call you sir or madam. Right? So you could say, Sir Uncle Johnjohn. Or Madam Uncle Johnjohn, depending if you're a man or a woman. But the job title was knight. And they wore armor, right? They wore metal suits to protect them when they had to do something dangerous. And because in the old days there weren't cars, they all rode horses. And so we're going to start this story with a knight on a horse, riding his horse really, really fast. And this knight in the story is going to attack a tree or a person hiding in a tree who's wearing an old-timey suit and kind of a weird, funny suit. Yeah, he's wearing a suit that is kind of, it's got like checkers on it. It's got stripes up and stripes left and right. And he's wearing a what's called a bowler hat. A bowler hat is a hat. It's kind of a formal, official looking hat, but it's round on the top. So this man's wearing a suit and a hat, and he's hiding in a tree, maybe because his suit is kind of weird. It's kind of a silly suit, and this knight maybe is attacking him, but maybe he's attacking the tree. We don't know. We will find out in just a moment. In the next picture, which shows us the round table. And do you know why I know it's the round table? It's because it's a table that is round, and it's got words on it that tell us also it's a round table. So it's both a round table, and it says so in case someone is not good with shapes or furniture vocabulary. Because maybe in the old days, maybe in a long, long, long time ago, people didn't have a lot of words for things, so they had to like put the words. Like for example, if you wanted to sit down in a chair, you had to look around your room for the thing that had the word chair on it and go, oh, okay, I need to sit down and I need to listen to Uncle Johnjohn tell a story. But I don't know where to sit. Oh, hey, here is a thing that has the word chair on it. Maybe that's how they knew. So in this story, we know that there is a knight who's going to attack a tree, or maybe a man in a really tacky suit and a bowler hat. But for now, we are watching old-timey people wearing old-timey clothes, eating dinner together. They're eating a chicken. They're eating noodles. They're eating bowls of soup and maybe some pumpkin pie and maybe some pecan pie. But the pecan pie is hot because there's steam coming off of it. And it's so delicious. But they're all sitting together at a round table. And they're not very happy. They're not very happy because this table does not have a lazy Susan. And a lazy Susan is not a person. It is a very cool thing to put on your table. It's also round and it turns. It turns and you can put food and stuff on it. And people can share food by turning the round thing on the table so that everybody can get a chance to have some of the hot pecan pie. I'm getting hungry for pecan pie. So why are these people wearing old-timey clothes? And more importantly, why are they wearing these really funny hats on their heads? Because they are wearing hats on their heads, but they're not like baseball hats. And they're not like Indiana Jones hats, and they're not zookeeper hats, and they're not train conductor hats. They're really, really weird hats. And it's very rude. It's rude to eat in a restaurant with your hat on. You should take your hat off when you sit down to eat. That is very polite. So why are they wearing hats? Well, the story is about the man in the silly suit and the bowler hat. And he's talking to the people with these strange costumes and these silly hats. And we know because he's talking to this very pretty young woman wearing a kind of a weirdo old-timey clothes because they are all wearing costumes from a long, long, long time ago. They are all wearing costumes from the time of the knights. Remember when I told you about the knights? And that's why we saw the knight riding the horse, and he wasn't attacking a tree or this strange guy in the tacky suit. Actually, it was part of what is called cosplay. So it's called cosplay because when it's not Halloween, and a lot of people and kinds of people, we call them nerds and geeks. When they get together and they wear costumes, it's not Halloween. It's called cosplay. And they are coming together for like an event, like a festival or a fair or a con. Like a con is an organized event for people to wear costumes and talk about nerd stuff and geek stuff. And I'm going to tell you a secret. Uncle Johnjohn, he's been to a few of those. And maybe the most common of them. And well, I've been to the ones where everybody dresses like old-time Japan. I've been to ones where people wear old-timey clothes from old times in England and Europe. Like the knights do, and like these people in our story do, and the weirdest ones, but weird in a super rad way, are anime cons. And so if you cosplay anime, that's a lot of work. It's really difficult to make those costumes, and it's super cool. And you know it's even weirder, so it's even cooler or radder are video game costumes. So if you can put on to cosplay for a video. Anyway, I'm getting ahead of the story. So what happens next? Oh, so we're going to see some of the different kinds of cosplay at this kind of like this old timey days in Europe. Okay, at this con. So this guy that we meet in the next part of our story, this guy is wearing a costume. He's cosplaying, okay? He's cosplaying as a shadow puppet. And if you don't know what a shadow puppet is when you make, instead of making the puppet characters for you to see, you're using shadows. So you use a very, very bright light to show a shadow of the puppet so that against a wall. So the wall shows the story, not the puppet, but the puppet makes a shadow. That's what you, so you're trying to make a story using shadows. And usually we use our hands, sometimes we can use our heads, and sometimes we can use, you know, things with shapes, and we can combine the shapes to make the shadows and tell a story. Sometimes they're very funny. And this guy in the story, who's at this cosplay event, his thing is he is the puppet. His whole self is the puppet. And so his costume looks like a combination between, you know, like a video game character and something from Shakespeare's time to like a ninja robe or like a Jedi, but all sorts of different ones because they make interesting shapes against the wall when he uses a light. And that's how he like tries to be cool. And I think maybe he is kind of cool. It is a little cool for him to do that. And something that we know about these cons, these nerd cons and these geek cons and these historical cons, is their parties. And also because nobody, it's very hot in there and everybody gets very sweaty, especially with their costumes. They get very sweaty. And after all day long inside a building, because they happen inside a building, you get very stinky. And a lot of nerds and a lot of geeks, they're not, they're not very careful about their BO, you know? And so when they go to these parties are always at the end of the day. That people have been in and out of different rooms talking about their hobbies and stuff. And they get all hot and they get all sweaty and very stinky. And they haven't brushed their teeth. And so they have bad breath. And so they go to these parties and they get even more sweaty and more stinky. And so there's sometimes you can tell the where the parties are, the rooms where the parties are. They're really, really kind of, the smell can be kind of thick, you know. It's hard to breathe in there. And so some people will be dancing and going kind of crazy because they don't know how to dance good. And some people, they just want to lie down because they're tired because they spent all day playing games, board games, card games, Pokemon and Magic the Gathering and all sorts of this stuff. And so they're really, really tired, especially in their costumes, which are really, really hot. So they just lie down and they just sleep in the middle of the party. But that's what they do. That's what they do. Some of the costumes, when the people cosplay, especially the old-timey stuff, they have to try to be really elaborate with their costumes. And that means they have to have accessories. You know, when I go out, sometimes I have an accessory, and my accessories might be a necktie. Because Uncle Johnjohn has a job and he has to try to look professional. So sometimes I wear a necktie. And sometimes I wear leather things on my arms to show I'm like a warrior. I'm a warrior of storytelling. And I can make people fall asleep. That reminds me, this is a bedtime story. So are you asleep yet? Did you fall asleep listening to my story? I hope you're falling asleep. If you're not falling asleep, I hope you're very relaxed. And I hope your eyes are getting sleepy. So at least if your eyes are getting sleepy, that's okay. That's okay. So I'm going to tell you some more about these cosplays. So having accessories, the more accessories you have and the more complicated and really wild they are, the better. So some cosplayers, when they have like a armor, is like really like big armor, and they have to like, it takes them like days and days and days to put it on and to take it off. Sometimes their swords would be like bigger than their whole bodies. And some of them, they will have like pets, like a pet dragon, right? A pet dragon with them, but it's not a real dragon. Don't worry. And maybe it'll look like a crocodile or an alligator. And no, don't ask me the difference because I don't know the difference between an alligator and a crocodile. But the point is, you're not allowed to have a crocodile at an anime con. But you can make kind of a thing that looks like one. And if you can have it so it opens its mouth open and close, and it's got wings, and the wings go up and down, and the eyes light up and stuff on it. And maybe it's got steam and smoke, like stick a couple of vape pens in its eyeballs and or its nose holes, and that smoke comes out. And that would be really, really cool. Anyway, I think this is a cool costume. And there's always one cosplayer who wants to be the king cosplayer of them all. And in my story, this story takes place in an old-timey story cosplay, right? So people are wearing like the old-timey knight's costumes. And this one cat, he's dressed like a super warrior knight with a super like elaborate and complicated armor with clouds on it and smoke coming out of it, and it's got flowers everywhere, and it's got a robe like he's a Jedi, and he's also got a big, long, huge, stinking sword, and it's really cool. By the way, the sword, totally made out of cardboard, but it's painted all silver and black and everything. And then there's the cosplayers who are like, who are just showing up because their friends are there, and they just put together whatever they have. Like they don't put any effort into it. No effort. Which is exactly what happened to the guy in the tacky suit. Remember the guy in the ugly suit? When he was like, okay, I'm gonna cosplay. So he just like threw a bunch of stuff in his backpack. You know, he went to like his brother and said, "Hey, give me like your gym shorts, man." And then went into his sister's room and said, "Hey, give me like your blouse and your bathrobe and stuff." And then went to his dad and said, "Hey, give me your hat from when you go to your fancy parties." And just threw them all into his backpack, and he went to this anime con. And he put it on. So like his costume, like he didn't put any effort. He didn't think about it at all. He just put it all together, and he looks kind of weird. He has kind of part of his suit, part of like a knight's outfit, part of like a basketball shorts and stuff. Like it's really, really dumb. So that's so you'll see that quite a bit. If you go to one of these cons, you'll see costumes like that. Like just somebody just like, he basically just put on a t-shirt that said, "Oh, I'm cosplaying." That's what it is. It's really dumb. Or let's just say you really, really want to participate. You want to go 100% into it, but you're broke. You don't have any money. You're just a kid. Well, it depends on the time. So if you go to one of these historical cons and you want to cosplay, just cosplay like one of the regular folks and just put like a bag over your head. And a stick and just say, "Okay, I'm just one of the regular, I'm like a farmer from the old time." And it'll work. It totally works. Totally works. It's also probably really comfortable too. This is what I wear when I go to bed. And some cosplayers, they go the other way and they just go completely crazy, and they and their group of friends are like super nerds and super geeks. They know everything about a CW show or a Disney show. They know everything about it, and so they'll all work together to make just the craziest costume. And it's like a multi-person costume. Like in this story, there's a guy who's dressed up like a king, and because he wants to show he's a king, his friends are like the servants, and they have to carry the king on a bed of a cloud bed, but really it's just like a bunch of wooden stuff just decorated with like, you know, cotton stuff to make it look like clouds, and all his friends. And by the way, this buddy who's the king, he's a little heavy, so it takes a lot of his friends to kind of lift him up and carry him around. And because he gets to be king because he promised he'll buy everybody a lunch if they carry him around for like 10 minutes to kind of make it look like, "Hey, I'm the king. Look at me. I've got servants." But they'll do it for like 10 minutes and then they'll put him down, and then he's just going to walk with the rest of them because come on, man, he's just one of them. And he's going to make up for it because he's going to buy them like hot dogs. But yeah, you're going to see that. You're going to see people who just completely go crazy, like really too much. And that is how we know about cosplay, cosplayers, remember? And this is what people do. Yeah. So it's really kind of cool. It's not a good idea to do it now, but you know what? Eventually, when you grow up and you're older, you should ask your older brother and your older sister about, anime con and comic con and dragon con and penny arcade, sometimes called PAX. That's kind of cool. And then you can cosplay about your favorite comic book character or TV show or anime. But you don't know any of this because you know what? You're asleep. You're asleep. Are you asleep now? Oh, you should be asleep. You should be asleep. And I'm gonna tell you something. The pictures that I used to make up this story, they come from a real story. And if you're interested, if you're curious about the real story, not the one that I told you, the story I told you was to help you fall asleep. But if you want to read a story about the knights from a long time ago and why the man in the bad suit ended up with the knights from a long time ago, you can read a story written by a really, really famous American author, Mark Twain. And Mark Twain wrote a book called A Connecticut Yankee in King Arthur's Court. So, if you want to read a cool book, you can read this book. And that means it's time for me to say good night. Good night.